To understand the present, we need to know our past. And the field of archaeology is always digging up new surprises. From long-lost weapons of war to surprising new skeletons, archaeology proves there's still a whole lot about our history left to be discovered. In this video, I'll show you 10 of the most amazing archaeological finds of recent years that shine a light on the past and change our understanding of the future. Amazing! Number 10, female warrior Vikings. What comes to mind when you think of Vikings? Guys in horned helmets? Friendly dragons? Well, a 10th century Swedish grave with female remains and military gear suggests Viking guys and gals kicked butt. The grave, first located in the 19th century in Birka, Sweden, a Viking trading hub, was considered unremarkable until an osteologist started studying the bones in 2014. 3 years later, they discovered that the skeleton belonged to a high-ranking female warrior. Bone specialists performed a series of DNA tests and found the ancient bones contained no Y chromosome, meaning they belonged to a biological female. So much for assumptions. Whilst both male and female Viking skeletons have been found in graves with weapons, the female skeletons were not previously assumed to belong to warriors. This mistake is a result of our 21st century assumptions and modern readings of Viking folklore, despite the fact there are plenty of Viking stories featuring female warriors. So there's two sides to this gender stereotype challenge, and some contrary evidence has complicated this picture of Viking gender equality. Some archaeologists believe the skeleton might not belong in that grave, and believe that because she didn't have any serious wounds, she wasn't a fighter. Other scientists say there's no evidence the grave was disturbed before being found, and only 2 out of 49 male warrior skeletons studied have bone-deep wounds, so it's possible she just never had a broken bone or bone-deep cut. Perhaps it's time we just accepted that Viking women could be fearsome too? Number 9. Japan's most feared battleship. In March 2015, American billionaire and Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen led his research team to the wreckage of Japan's largest battleship, the Musashi. Allen's tweet, "World War II battleship Musashi sank 1944 is found," followed 11 years of intense archaeological surveying. Using historical counts from the US and Japan, Allen's team searched 477 square miles, about the size of Nashville, Tennessee, and used a multi-beam echo sounder and autonomous underwater vehicle to map volcanic ridges dominating that area of the Subiyan Sea. The deep ridges varied by 6,000 feet across very short distances, making the search for the Musashi incredibly difficult. Eventually, the Musashi was discovered, overgrown with coral in the depths of the ocean. Measuring 863 feet long, weighing 73,000 tons, and carrying the largest cannons ever mounted onto a warship, it was a juggernaut. With the success of Japan's imperial forces in Asia, the Musashi threatened a Japanese victory on the high seas and terrified the Americans. Its sister ship, the Yamamoto, packed more firepower than the most modern ships the Allies had available, capable of unleashing great destruction on Asia's coastal cities. But despite its impressive artillery, the Musashi sank after attacks from Australian and American pilots during the Battle of Leyte Gulf. Over 1,000 people died, and with them sank a crucial piece of world history, until now. Number 8. Florida's Neolithic Graves. In 2018, when a group of divers stumbled across a human jawbone in the swampy mud of the Florida shoreline, their first reaction was to call the police and report a murder. But forensic investigators soon discovered that the human remains weren't from a recent unsolved mystery, but from a far, far older source. The bones were around 7,000 years old and marked the entrance to an ancient Native American burial site. A team of underwater archaeologists, using chopsticks and pastry brushes, set to work and eventually found the remains of 6 more Neolithic individuals. The incredible preservation of these bones was a result of what is called bog burials. Whilst there's a similar one near Cape Canaveral, bog burials exist worldwide and include famous graves like the Tolland Man and the Yelling Woman. These burials preserve remains under an airtight seal of mud, which stops the body from rotting and even preserves the internal organs. Facial expressions, clothing, and even last meals can survive for many thousands of years. Some of the Florida discoveries even had intact brains. With so much Native American history destroyed by European settlers, Discoveries like these help piece together a clearer image of America's original inheritance. Number 7, the Dark Age Stronghold. Between the 4th and 7th century AD, the lost Celtic kingdom of Rheged controlled trade between Europe, Scotland, and northern England. The kingdom was ruled by four kings, with King Urien at the head, and it became an influential power after the Romans left in 4 AD. The Rheged fortress marked its borders with Pictish rune petroglyphs. Picts inhabited areas north of the rivers Forth and Clyde in modern-day Scotland and were absorbed by the Celts in 11 AD. Neither the Picts nor the early Celts wrote much, leaving their history coded in untranslatable pictographs. For over 2,000 years, evidence of the kingdom lay undiscovered. In fact, many previously believed it never existed, due to the area's connection to the legends of King Arthur. But in 2017, the stronghold of this mysterious kingdom was unearthed, casting a new light on our understanding of the Dark Ages, and leave many historians wondering, how did we lose an entire kingdom? It's currently being excavated and believed to be a royal stronghold, possibly the core of the kingdom. Number 6, rare glass spearhead found. In 2017, on Rottnest Island in Australia, a group of students found a large, emerald-green glass spearhead. They were excited by the discovery, but why? Like Native American reservations, Rottnest Island housed indigenous Australians from 1838 to 1902. Approximately 3,700 indigenous men and boys spent time there, effectively in prison-like conditions. Rottnest commonly yields 30,000-year-old artifacts, but more modern pieces, like this, demonstrate how archaic technologies and modern junk can be combined to make usable goods, an early recycling program. This spearhead was made from scrap pieces of glass using a millennia-old process called flaking, just like flint tools and weapons in the Stone Age. Basically, the stone would be pressed against another tool with pressure to take thin flakes off the side to fashion a sharp tip. The spear tip is at least 100 years old and would have been traded between the inmates and used to hunt quokkas, a small rat-like marsupial which lent the island its name. Number 5, America's Lost Soldiers. Underwater archaeology has proven invaluable recently, and was key to half of the discoveries mentioned in this video. In May 2017, scientists from Project Recover, dedicated to finding remains of American servicemen, located two B-25 Mitchell bombers near Papua New Guinea. These two bombers sealed the fate of at least six missing airmen. After 70 years underwater and riddled with anti-aircraft rounds, planes don't look much like planes. Teams used everything, from oral histories to submarines, to locate the missing bombers, part of a huge effort by the Department of Defense to work out what happened to as many as 73,000 missing World War II servicemen. Archaeologists also found the heavy cruiser USS Indianapolis 18,000 feet underneath the Philippine Sea. Using the same techniques that found the Musashi, archaeologists searched 600 square miles to find the entombed ship. Japanese torpedo strikes sank the USS Indianapolis in 12 minutes. Of 1,200 men, 300 died immediately, leaving 900 dehydrated and salt-sickened men to fend for themselves in shark-infested waters. The US Navy was unaware the ship sank, and a distress signal was never sent. It was only when a passing plane spotted survivors days later that the alarm was raised. The loss of the USS Indianapolis is one of the worst disasters in US Navy history. And only with this recent discovery can the remaining 316 survivors gain closure. Number 4, the Lost Viking Town. Vikings are known for pillage and plunder, but in England in the 9th century AD, they may have changed their tactics. The Torksey Winter Camp, discovered in Lincolnshire after decades of searching, was more of a large, bustling town than a raider camp, and was serviced by permanent metal smiths and ship repair facilities. Women and children also lived here, and the 300 gaming pieces found, for a game called Hnefatafl, a kind of Viking chess, meant they often had fun too. Excavations in 2017 produced thousands of everyday artifacts, gold and silver ingots, and an amazing number of coins. Coins are especially valuable, as they allow good dating of archaeological sites, but what was most fascinating about the 350 coins is that around half are dirhams from the Middle East. This discovery allowed archaeologists to piece together a complex ancient trade map, showing that the Vikings traded with the Middle East, swapping goods and ideas through Scandinavia and back down to the UK. So maybe after all these years, we've got the Vikings wrong? It certainly seems there's a more cultured, business-minded side to these feared warriors. Number 3. The Secret Henge. Avebury Henge is already an awe-inspiring ancient monument, but in 2017, archaeologists discovered the site is even more important than previously thought. The giant stone circle is 990 feet across and was built around 5,000 years ago. That's just after the first mummification in Egypt and before writing began in the Middle East. But using ground-penetrating radar and soil-resistant surveys, archaeologists from two English universities discovered an even older structure beneath Avebury Henge. It was 90 square feet and stood around a 21 feet tall, 100 ton obelisk, erected at least 500 years before Avebury Henge was built. It was a deliberate construction that almost certainly had a religious purpose, and most excitingly, it was square, indicating it was perhaps the frame of a building or temple at the center of the Neolithic community. It's clear that it underwent repairs and restructuring over many hundreds of years, and served different purposes as the ancient British religion morphed over time. Apart from that, we still have some secrets to learn about its exact purpose or method of construction. The discovery has astounded archaeologists and left them scratching their heads at how such a huge structure could have gone unnoticed for so long. Number 2. Ancient Underwater Roman City. This next find off the coast of modern-day Tunisia in North Africa is another example of the incredible advances in underwater archaeology. Since 2010, an Italian-Tunisian team searched for a legendary submerged city that, like Atlantis, disappeared under the waves from a massive tsunami in 365 AD. In 2018, divers found the 20-hectare site of Neapolis with intact streets and monuments, suggesting a settlement of sophistication and wealth. Most striking for archaeologists were the 100 tanks used to produce garum, a popular condiment in ancient Rome made out of fermented fish. It seems the Neapolis elite owed their wealth to garum and saltfish, both delicacies that were exported to the bigwigs in Rome. Excavations are ongoing, but it won't be long before we find out what other secrets Neapolis took with it to the bottom of the sea. Number 1. Grilling the cave people way. Archaeologists often use mundane things to challenge preconceptions. Enter Pot 3258 from the Friesach IV Mesolithic site in Germany. Proteomic analysis of the pot's residue suggests a range of specific and deliberate modifications of ancient food proteins. In normal English, this means that these 6,300-year-old chefs cooked their food in a precise, gourmet way, with care to combine different flavors and cooking techniques in exactly the same way a professional chef would today. The Mesolithic chef who held pot number 3258 in 4300 BCE concocted a fish broth from fresh carp roe boiled on a low heat under leaves. The leaves added special flavor and kept in heat, and the combination of ingredients would have been similar to Asian-style soups you get in high-end restaurants today. Elsewhere in Jordan, archaeologists found charred flatbread remains at a site that's about 14,500 years old. That means we made bread 4,000 years before purposeful agriculture. Being the oldest bread in the world, it looks like a whole grain bread made with a mix of wild grains, the first artisan loaf, perhaps? These important finds radically change our understanding of the Stone Age. They show a picture not of men with clubs eating raw meat and grunting, but of an age of intellectual exploration and gourmet craftsmanship. Other finds back this up, and suggests our ancestors were in most ways just like us. In Neanderthal burial sites in France, cave paintings now point to the existence of a complex Stone Age calendar system. Researchers now think animals painted on cave walls represented specific celestial configurations from when the scene was painted, a meteor shower or comet strike, for instance. If researchers are right, the theory suggests early humans had a much greater grasp of chronology than thought. So, which of these archaeological finds do you find the most surprising? Should we revise our stereotypes of Vikings and cavemen? Let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching.